Hello everyone, welcome back to the new video of this tutorial. In this video, we will be installing the Laravel and we will be storing the multiple data into the database. So for that, at first let's go to our command prompt. Now let's redirect it where we want to install the Laravel project. Now let's run Laravel new and name it as multi insert, and it will take some time to install the Laravel project. So until then, let's go to our laravel.com, and now the Laravel 8 has been released recently, so there has been some changes in our routes. So for that, let's go to our proc and here update guide. So here you can see all the changes that have been made in the Laravel 8. So you can see these are the changes that we need to make. So here let's go to our route section directly. So you can see, okay, here. Now this is how we have to define the route. Next, here you can see we have to import the namespace, or you can use this method. And if you want the previous styling of the routing, then you can go in your route service provider. And then after, you can write this code inside the put function. If you do so, the routes will be work as before. Here I'll be using this new method of the routes. So let's see, okay. So I'll pause this video until my Laravel project will insert, and then I'll be back. Okay, now the project, Laravel project, has been installed successfully. Now let's go to project file. Let's say PHP artisan serve, and here let's run. Okay, you can see now the Laravel has been installed successfully. So let's open our Laravel project in the VS Code real quick. Let's close this welcome message. Let's close this message. Let's open terminal here. Okay, now as you can see, the file's details. So now let's create a first controller. So PHP artisan AA controller. It has party controller. Okay, now let's go with our multi-controller. Well, at first let's define an index function. And let's return it to our given name multi-page. Here we haven't created our web file name multi-page part yet. So let's do that. Let's create a new file, play.php. Let's copy this. Okay, now let's paste it. Let's change this to multi insert. Then copy multi controller and replace the user controller with it. Then move this use all the way to the top. And let's define the name multi insert for this route.
Before that, let's build some data here.
Before that, let's go to our level 3 school. Okay, then. Now, bootstrap section, bootstrap, core, then after tables. I'm using our tables because we need this. So that I'm directly copy this. Copy, okay, then our project error. Yes, I want it to be this. Multi, okay, you can see my project is working, it's showing the data correctly. Now let's change the table header with the name, brand name, model, and the ref attribute with the class button. Okay, now here let's remove this zone. Let's write the select tag to select our brand name. Then just remove this all. Now let's define the input type for the model name. Name should be model. It is model. Just in this add row to each row, some button, photo button, okay, I think this will do. So in the browser, let's refresh the page. Okay, so now what I want here is when I click in this plus button, I want to add the row, and when I click on this minus button, I want to remove the. So for that here, the file, let's define the JS file. Function. Let's copy on this. Let's paste it. we done now, then after let's second it to our 40. body.com click it to it is since our minus tab is here, minus button is here, so its parent will be td. TD parent will be TR, perhaps we have to delete the whole TR button. So for that parent dot parent, parent dot no. Okay, I think this will go, so let's check it, let's refresh the page. Let's add, okay, so the data is adding, let's change this to Apple, I'll add something. Okay, let's add first remove this call. You can see the Apple has been removed, now remove this data. You can see the data has been removed successfully. Okay. Add the data to, so now what we'll be doing is, now let's insert this data to our database. So for that, we have, let's go to the top. And here let's define our submit button. Type should be submit and produce it again. Submit. Submit data. So let's copy this. Then after let's go to multi-controller here. At first, let's just return all good. Okay, at first, let's just see if it could be forming passing data to the controller or not. Okay, here we got the syntax error. Let's see if we have done wrong in our code. Okay, where I am using the performance, let's put it. Now let's refresh the page. Okay, you can see at first let's just submit like this. The post method is not supported. Method post, okay, that's post. Again, let's refresh the page. Okay, All good. So it's sending our data to our submit data and somehow it's remove this part. For that, let's create a model. Since I have written /m, the migration, the model will create a migration in the snapcase name, where you can see in the database migration. Here you can see snapcase and the snapcase plural name. So let's copy this. Here we are opting CTE protect dollar table. Okay, if we don't here in model, if we don't tell the model which table to use, then it will just simply take the camel case plural version of this multimodal, which is multimodals here it has been created. So here no need to define the table. But if you have got different name of the table other than this multimodal camel case, then you have to define it as like this protected model. Okay, let's write it here. So let's copy this and let's put Sunday and let's paste it here. Okay, now let's define the protected dollar fill label. Okay, here now we are defining this fillable property here because we must assigning our value to the database. We can say we'll be submitting the mass data to our database. For that we need this dollar property here. So it is pra then model. Correct. Dollar data dollar data model equals to dollar request model and here dollar key. Correct me to save dollar data save. Okay, no, I have forgotten one thing. I haven't defined the database on it. Okay. So let's define this. let's define the patterns. Let's create a new database and let's make the templates to insert. Create an octal. Okay, so here in models you can see we have defined these two. So we need to define a size. Either we can define it here like doing this, or we can choose simply going simply in the sorry. Which is the app service provider and inside put method schema So now let's clear this and let's simply run. You can see this all the data has been, all the table has been inserted here. So you can insert multi-models. You can see there aren't any data now. So let's refresh the page. Correct, okay, let's submit the data. Invalid arguments. I think I haven't defined this size. Correct. Since we are passing the multiple data, it's multiple values, so it's not happy. So let's submit this data.
But the data has been inserted into the database successfully, but also it is showing the gate error. I think this error is coming from the redirect route from our controller. Let's check it. Then I will submit it. So I haven't passed any messages. You can pass it from your route to show the success message there. So okay guys, this much is this video. See you in the next video.
If you haven't subscribed on my channel, then subscribe and click on bell icon so that you will be the first one to get the notification of my new video.